Welcome to the Global Pulse, a short video series where our experts break down a trending topic in international business and why it matters to you.
Supply chains have had an important impact both on the spread as well as the response to pandemics throughout history. So, for example, in the early 1900s, it would take anywhere from 6 to 9 months for a pandemic to spread around the globe. Obviously, what we've seen with the coronavirus is that has been dramatically compressed in terms of time. So supply chains, because they integrate companies and businesses and people worldwide, have in essence become corridors, if you will. And supply chain hubs have become corridors for the transmission of these kinds of viruses and flus. Ports, airports, these are major hubs in both managing and also transmitting the virus. So we need to remember the dual-edged, the two sides of supply chain in relation to a pandemic. Corporations have learned a lot from this. The SARS epidemic taught them they needed to create worldwide task forces and response mechanisms that could deal with things like telework. How do their employees, reduce contact and reduce the transmission of the virus? Vendors, how do we have alternative vendors that can be outside of the area of maximum impact of the virus? These sorts of concerns rose heavily after SARS and have led to supply chain risk management programs specifically focused on epidemics and pandemics in major corporations. The strategic importance of this response is that after about 3 months, buffer stocks, strategic inventory stocks, get depleted. And the protections that we see in industries like pharmaceuticals, where any interruption in the supply of feedstocks from China, which about 80% of the feedstocks in the pharmaceutical industry worldwide come from there, can result after about 3 months in the lack of availability of critical drugs and pharmaceuticals in places like CVS and Target and Walmart, so that you go to fill out a prescription and unfortunately it may not be there. So this is the concern. But we're hoping that the lessons learned from SARS has created enough strategic inventory to withstand the volatility of the next 3 months or so.